is Generative Fill really gonna be paid? Can I remove the beta now that Generative Fill's in the main version? And is it 24 or 25? And by the way, where are my presets, actions, etc., plugins? I'm gonna answer all your burning questions on Photoshop 2024 right now. Let's start with the big question. Is Generative Fill paid or is it free? So generative credits apply every time you generate something in Generative Fill. Now, number one, it's not gonna start until November the 1st. So every time that you use Generative Fill, Generative Expand, it's gonna count as one generative credit. And I think I know where they're going with this, and I'll talk about that in a second. But first of all, what do you get and what do you pay for? So it's like Midjourney and a lot of the other AI generators, you get priority generation, which means that an AI credit just gives you fast generation. When you run out of the fast generation, if the servers are busy, then your generation is going to take a little bit longer. We don't know how much longer or even if it will slow it down during those busy times. But the bottom line is if you're a paid subscriber, no, you don't have to pay. Since we're talking about Photoshop, if you're on a Creative Cloud, the full version, you get 1,000 generative credits a month. If you're on single app, like maybe just Photoshop, you get 500 credits a month. If you're on a Creative Cloud photography plan, you get 250 credits per month, but if you join after November the 1st, you only get 100 credits per month. So these credits refresh kind of like the minutes on your phone plan. At a certain time every month, those are going to refresh and you're going to have the full amount of credits. If you don't use them all, they can't carry over. You can't pull them. You can't share them with people. But what happens if you run out of credits? Do you start paying? Well, you have two options. So what happens is it's kind of like your internet when you get unlimited bandwidth. Once you go over the bandwidth, then it's possible things could be slowed down. And it's the same thing here. They're not going to charge you extra, but if the servers are busy, your generations could take longer during those peak times. So at this point, we don't know how much it'll slow down, or if it will slow down all the time, or if it will just slow down during certain times. I guess we'll find out in time. Now, you have the ability to purchase more priority credits. So it says on Adobe's website that if we run out of credits, then we can get more of these priority processing credits at $5 a month for 100 credits. Now, let me just put this into perspective. Most people are not going to use 1,000 credits. Many, many people won't even use the 250 credits, but we'll just see how this goes. Now, other things like the remove tool do not use generative credits, neither do the other AI tools in Photoshop, just generative fill and generative expand. The second burning question ties into this first one. Has the 1024 by 24 limit been removed? And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. From what I can see on the Adobe site, yes and no. It's been increased, but it hasn't been removed. It's limited to 2K, which is 2000 pixels square. So that can't be stretched or expanded. If the selection is larger than 2000 pixels across or 2000 pixels high, it's gonna take a 2000 image and it's just gonna just stretch it to fit. So if your selections are really large, you're gonna see very soft images or low resolution kind of patches. If you're working in blocks less than 2000, the resolution is gonna be the same as the image. Now I did another tutorial which showed how to do it on 1024. Now you can just do the same thing, check out that video. And if you generate in small blocks, you're not gonna see any issues. From what I can see on Adobe's website, it says here, what about future generative AI capabilities? And it says it could be things like 3D and video or higher resolution image and vector that may incur additional generative credits. So if you look at some of the previews that you'll see on the Firefly site and kind of read what's on Adobe's site, the writing's on the wall. This is my prediction, and this could be completely wrong, but based on what I'm reading here and what I'm seeing here, it looks like we're gonna be generating these images, and then when we find something that we like, we're gonna be able to upscale it perhaps, kind of like what we can do on every other platform. So, you know, when you're working in Midjourney, you generate four, you find one you want, you upscale it, and it costs you a credit. So my guess is when you wanna do something in higher resolution, we're gonna be able to upscale it at some point, and then maybe it's gonna charge us 2 credits, or maybe 5 credits, or whatever it's gonna charge us for that upscaling depending on the resolution. And this just kind of makes sense because in order to run this AI, Adobe needs to have very massive data centers and very heavy computing, and it's very expensive to run this. So it kind of just makes sense. One of the most popular questions I got from people is, hey, now that Generative Fill is in Photoshop, can I just get rid of the beta? Do I still need it? Well, that's entirely up to you. The beta can run alongside the other version of Photoshop. And in a second, I'll show you how to link it from Lightroom because that's another question people were having. So you can keep it if you want, or you can just work in 2024. Now, the advantage in having the beta is as new features come out, they're going to be released. Not all of them, but some of them, they try it out in beta first, and then some of those make it into mainstream Photoshop, and some of them don't. So if you want to experiment with new features, keep it by all means. If all you wanted was Generative Fill, you can safely uninstall beta and continue to work in Photoshop 2024 with all the features that I've taught up to this date are all there in 2024. And speaking of 2024, there's some confusion. I had some people say, hey, I was looking for 2024 and all I see is Photoshop 2025. If you go into your Creative Cloud and you go to update Photoshop, it's going to show version 25 on here. In fact, if I click there and we look at other versions, we can see it's Photoshop version 25. But this is just the version of Photoshop. This is called Photoshop 2024 because on Creative Cloud, all the apps are going to be called 2024. But these might be different versions of Photoshop or Illustrator because every time they do a major update, that goes by one. They didn't start, you get it. Where are my presets and plugins? Another question I'm getting. Okay, here's what I recommend. So whenever you do a full version, not a dot version, but a full version upgrade, make sure that you turn on Keep Previous Version. If you do that, it's going to install the new version of Photoshop alongside your old version, and this is going to safely let you manually migrate all your presets over. And you can go under the Presets Manager, and you can export the presets, and you can bring them into Photoshop. I've done other tutorials on that. Check them out. Now, for plugins, when you do a full version, you're going to have to reinstall those plugins. If for some reason you can't reinstall these plugins, this is why I told you to keep the previous version. So then when you need those plugins, work on that previous version until you're able to migrate all your plugins and presets and everything over to the latest version. And then when you're happy with it and you feel like it's running smoothly and stably, then you can uninstall the old version. So what if you uninstall the old version and now you find the new version is buggy with a tool you need, but it's gone? Launch your Creative Cloud app. Click the three-dot menu next to Photoshop, choose Other Versions. So there's version 25, which is 2024. And the previous versions were Photoshop 2023. And there's all the versions here. So you can install one of these earlier versions on here, even all the way back to 22, which I believe was Photoshop 2021 or something like that. And so you can install these other versions and have them run alongside. So before you launch it, make sure you're launching Photoshop 2024. The icon looks the same in 2023 and you could run it. That might be why some people said, hey, I installed the latest version, but the features aren't there. Because you might have installed it, but make sure you launched the correct version. Another big one is the tools not showing up in the toolbar because you can create workspaces. If you created a workspace before the feature existed inside of Photoshop, it's not going to show in the toolbar. But this is really easy to fix. Click and hold the menu in the toolbar, choose Edit Toolbar, and it will show under the Extra Tools. Because that preset, those tools didn't exist at the time. Now you can just go in here and you can choose Restore Defaults, and that will add everything in there as a default. Click Done. Now, if you do this and you have a workspace, make sure you update that workspace now. Otherwise, the next time you choose the workspace, that tool will disappear again. So when I'm going from Lightroom to open the images, it no longer opens in the version that I want. Okay, so if we're in here and I right click and I choose to edit, and it wants to open in Photoshop beta, but I want to have it in 2024 or whatever version. Go up under the preferences. And then you'll see under external editing, Photoshop version. notice that we have beta and 2024. If you haven't installed 2024 yet, you won't see it. If you do, make sure you restart first. Choose 2024. That's it. If I right click now, I choose edit in Photoshop 2024. Now I could change this to 2023 or beta, depending on what I have installed there. I think I've answered the main questions that people have been asking me. Let me know in the comments underneath if I answered your question. And if you have a different problem, then drop it in the comment and let us know. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. Now check out the video here where I show all the new features inside of Photoshop 2024/version 25. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.